But ladies and gentlemen, I must tell you a couple of things. So please, we go live in just a couple of moments. We go live with a main event. We have a big pre-fight filmed up. Now, could we have the music, please? Oh, thank you. Right off. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, David Price has asked me to ask you, please, respect the anthems of both countries. There was a little bit of doing last time. He wants Liverpool to show its class to the world. So when we have our Stars and Stripes played, please respect it and be very, very loud. For God save the Queen. So we're almost ready to go, ladies and gentlemen. I'm sure you're in good voice. We've got a little treat for you. Well, ladies and gentlemen, here we go with the big fight build-up. Would you please welcome, starting us off, Mr. Mark Kirby. with respect
to the late drummer Lee Rigby, we have the drums of the 2nd Battalion Duke of Lancaster's Regiment. And now, ladies and gentlemen, we have a very special occasion and a very special guest. He was the 1988 Seoul Olympics super heavyweight gold medalist. He turned professional in 1989, and within 16 months, he had won European heavyweight gold. Commonwealth and British titles followed. Successful defences means he is now the proud holder of the Lord Lonsdale Challenge belt. Over 14 years, he had 19 title defences. Ladies and gentlemen, would you please welcome into the ring the undisputed heavyweight champion of the world, Lennox Lewis! Well, ladies and gentlemen, it's time for the big one. Frank Maloney is proud to bring you redemption. So would you please welcome to the ring from the USA, Tony the Tiger Thompson.
Come on, man.
The big man from Maryland via Washington to the strains of I'm gonna knock you out. A statement of intent perhaps for Tony Thompson, who did exactly that 5 months ago. He didn't read the script then. Will he again tonight? Tony Thompson came into this very tune against their own Paul Smith. It didn't work that night. Liverpool fans will be hoping that it's going to fall on deaf ears this evening. Johnny Thompson, full of the business, full of the chat, all week. Can he deliver? And a fatal blow to the career and the future of David Price. Tony Thompson has pure warrior written across his t-shirt. I suspect it'll be much cagier than that in the early rounds.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, it's time to welcome from Liverpool, David Price.
As David Price makes his way amidst bedlam here at the Echo Arena. It's a walk he made some 5 months ago when he was expected to smash his way through Tony Thompson, make a statement, and then make his way onto the world scene. That wasn't on the script. Thompson with a second round stoppage. Well, that ripped up the storyline, and David Price is back. It's going to be the making or the breaking of me, he says, in the build-up to this one. We're about to find out which it is. Wonderful atmosphere. Tony Thompson is jig-jogging to James Brown, eyeballing David Price at the other end. He's lapping up every single minute of this. They exchange glances from either side of the ring. It is bubbling up beautifully here in Liverpool. Is it going to be fireworks or perhaps a cagey start as it unfolds before our eyes? Read on, watch this, stay tuned.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, at this time, can I ask you please to remain standing? Respect the anthems of both countries. As Mr. Mark Riley plays the national anthem of the United States of America. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Ladies and gentlemen, you're all very welcome here to the Echo Arena Liverpool, where Frank Maloney is very proud to bring you Redemption. 12 rounds of international heavyweight boxing. We're live and exclusive across the USA on Well TV, and a very warm welcome also to the viewers here in the UK on Box Nation, the home of boxing. Our sponsors are Southwark Metals, the UK's number one for scrap metal recycling, Lonsdale, Lomans Limited, and the Iron Gym. All our officials ringside, appointed by the British Boxing Board of Control. Steward in charge is Mr. Charles Giles. Medical officers, doctors, Banks, Jones, and Gruel. Our three scoring judges at ringside, from Fleetwood, Mr. Steve Gray, from Wellingborough, Mr. John Keane, from Paisley, Mr. Victor Loughlin. The timekeeper from Warrington, Mr. Andrew East. And when the bell rings, the referee in charge from Twickenham. Please welcome A-star referee, Mr. Marcus McDonald. And so, ladies and gentlemen, in attendance here at ringside, the officials are ready, the boxers are ready. Are you ready for the main event? In the blue corner, wearing black with white trim, weighing in 18 stone 7 pounds, bringing to the ring a 40 fight record, 37 wins, 25 inside the scheduled distance, only 3 defeats. Former WBO Intercontinental Champion and 2 times world title challenger. From Washington, D.C., in the USA, he is Tony the Tiger Thompson. And across the ring in the red corner, wearing red with gold, weighing in 17 stone 12 pounds. Bringing to the ring a 16 fight record, 15 wins, 13 inside the scheduled distance, with only 1 defeat. He is still the reigning heavyweight champion of Great Britain and the Commonwealth, from Liverpool, David Grant!
David, I spoke to you about in the dressing room. You know what I expect. At the professor, at all times, obey my instructions. Watch your heads, keep it clean. Any questions? Let's go to work.
David Price, Tony Thompson shake their heads. No questions, but answers coming up right now. And the answers to the questions that have been asked in the build-up, was that a fluke punch? Can David Price regroup? Where is he at in his boxing career? David Price has said that attack is my best form of defence. Tony Thompson's exuded confidence in the build-up and a little more movement from the American and front foot action than we're accustomed to. Last time around, Thompson was on the back foot, prepared to let Price come to me. Let's fly with the left hand. ...38 knockouts between this pair. Remember, Tony Thompson has only been beaten three times in his career and only twice in 35 fights over 13 years, and those to Vladimir Klitschko. This guy doesn't get beat often. Study of focus and intensity on David Price's face. He's managing to slip away from any of those jabs. And that smile that we saw from Thompson in the locker room beforehand is already painted across his face. He is full of confidence.
David's just got enough fault for any of these mind games, the smiles, the smirks, and just keep his jab up, keep focused on the job. Don't worry about negativity. Don't worry if the crowd start getting a bit restless. Just do your job. Just keep safe, keep the boxing, and just keep picking Thompson off.
No real jab yet from David Price. Can he get Thompson under control? That'll be step A. Already he'll be feeling better about being back in the ring. They're getting close. There's a short right hand from Price, but those skirmishes so dangerous for both of them. Another right hand from Price. There is palpable tension in the air here. Every set of eyes glued on the ring. A left hand from Thompson, cushioned by Price as he leaned away. And better jab from Price. High level, tense chess match unfolding through the first couple of minutes. A little bit of movement from Tony Thompson. We get through the first round, an eyeball from Thompson. It was full of the business in the early stages. Price will be, I suspect, relieved to get that 3 minutes under his belt.
Everything you can see is there, OK? Don't lunge him from too far out. And he's trying to go through the body, right, so you bring your hand down. So forget it, all right? He's just trying to bring your hand down, and he's going to faint and come over the top. Listen, patient start. Just keep trying to get closer with that right hand. Okay, make sure you get your foot on the outside. You're in the fight now. Hey, this is it now. Okay, just keep going. You've got 12 rounds.
Well, that's it. You're in the fight now. The point I was making, that let's just get back into action and then we can start working on it. But did Price do enough in that first round to please you, Paul?
He's pleasing me because I want to see him boxing. I want to see him not what everyone else is used to, just steaming in and knocking kids out left, right and centre. It's not going to work that way. You need the valuable rounds under your belt and you need to play it smart with Tony Thompson after last time.
Quick right left from David Price immediately as they came out, as Thompson reached in. Well, there was the feeling back in February that Thompson might have come over for one last payday and he simply lucked out with a fluke punch. There's no doubt he's not come over to lie down. Not one bit of it. And David Price is going to have to work him out and throw the right punches at the right time. Oh, big right hand. Uppercut as Price came in close, getting a bit untidy.
Do not use your elbow.
I sense that Price was getting a bit carried away again. Head from Thompson.
Nice jab.
That's what we want to see. We know the explosive power is there for Price. 6 first round knockouts, 11 inside the first 3 rounds. That'll come. Tony Thompson coming forward. Oh, uppercut from Thompson. Let's fly with the left, and Price a little bit untidy. He's becoming a scrap.
He's got to stay tight inside, David.
This is, I suspect, not the instruction for David Price. He's getting dragged into a fight here. It has to be deep down, a small part of Price who wants to prove to everyone that he has got a chin at world level, yeah, among the big boys.
Yeah, we've just got to stay switched on and get back to the game plan, get back to the basics and jab. That's nice.
Right hand from Price. Thompson on the ropes. He's playing possum. He was hurt. Back comes Thompson. Another big Price. Punch, and he was tangled, and that was a slip. Definitely a slip and ruled as such by Marcus McDonald, but Tony Thompson probably looks across to his corner. Lennox Lewis on his feet in the far side. Punches ringing all over the place. Right hand!
Oh, what a shot!
Right hand.
Two, three.
Thompson down!
Long run!
Looks across to his corner. Right hand! Counts it eight. He's back up. Referee is alert. Just a few seconds of the round left. Crowd on their feet. You won't hear the bell. There it goes. Big round for David Price. And perhaps redemption is on the menu after all. Well, I don't suspect it's the
box. That was a big right hand.
Wasn't it just?
Right over. Just overhand right. Every bit of David's body weight in it. And then a little slugfest towards the end. This right hand, every bit of power right in the side of his ear.
Just a little short right hand, wasn't it? As they both leaned in. It was scrappy and untidy. They were winging away.
Good shot. Thompson done well recovering, done well getting up and recovering. We'll see what he's got left next round.
He says he's all right to his corners. He takes a big glug of water. And David Price needs to be careful. There's the jab from Price. The crowd on their feet already at the start of this third.
Good way, good counter from David.
Big right hand. Again, it was a clip on the top of the head as Thompson complains. Every time the right hand lands, Thompson's in trouble. They trade left hands. Price has got to be so careful though. Oh, drama. Real drama here in the third. Thompson's wounded, but he remains dangerous. Another right hand from Price, and another.
Good work. Nice, lovely combination.
Yeah, but it's
short
all...
left hook, right uppercut.
He just refuses to throw a jab, Price, doesn't he? Well, those that thought they were going to feel their way through negatively to the middle rounds in the second half of the fight, forget that, folks. And Thompson with a short right hand. Price needs to get his hands up here. David Price blowing a bit after that assault. Still a minute of this third to go. Good uppercut, and again from Price. Two big right hands. And Thompson's coming back for more. It looks as though one punch at any moment will finish it. Which direction's it coming in? Price with the right hand. Oh, it's one of those fights that there'll be people behind the sofa completely Don't worry, folks, we'll let you know when it's all over. Right hand on the left from Price. He's throwing all the big artillery. Lovely body shot. Price has thrown a load of punches in this round. No clipping right from Thompson, who's still in this. Closing seconds of the third. Big round again. Oh, and a big left hand from Tony Thompson, just to remind Price that he's in this fight. Back comes Price. Big round for Price. But he put in a shift. He threw a lot of punches. And a weedy stagger back to his corner.
Tell him what to do.
Thompson complaining about that shot being on the back of the head. It wasn't thrown that way, you know, it just landed that way. He's leaned in, it landed on the back of the head. But he's certainly all there about him, you know, he's got it in him to complain to the referee, then he's certainly not it.
Price is on top, Paul, but it's a bit scrappy, probably scrappier than his corner would like.
Yeah, and probably more scrappy than David Price would like, but listen, for the people that doubted that he was going to be gun-shy, you know, he's certainly not gun-shy tonight. I was one of the people that thought this fight might go into like 7 or 8 rounds of, you know, maybe even a little bit bored and just feeling each other out, but Davidson eventually grind him down. I was wrong as well. This is an entertaining fight.
And Tony Thompson, in each of his last 8 wins, they've all been by stoppage. The danger is always there. Thompson down in the second. Hurried, hassled, and troubled in the third. Here we are into the fourth, and it's been breathless stuff so far. And a right uppercut from Tony Thompson. Price walked onto that. It's a good scrap for the big boys, isn't it? Thompson on the ropes just above us. Right hand from Price again. He's looking to go to the body. He's trying to get Thompson to lower his hands.
Yeah, the ball going to the body. Thompson's going there. I think Thompson's going there, especially to try and target David's body into the air, not just to bring the hands down.
You sense if Thompson's going to land, it's going to be a counter punch when Price is on the attack. When Price covers up, now the odd uppercut, he's not troubled when he's under that sort of pressure. Nice right hand from David Price. A minute and a half gone. He's got to set it up, Price.
Thompson's just a typical cagey old pro, you know, very comfortable when bigger men are throwing shots at him.
And he went 17 rounds with Klitschko, didn't he? And although it looked like the end when he fought him out in Bern,
it was a nice shot.
Right uppercut there again from Price. The pace has just dipped, and probably just as well. I don't know if that was a grimace or a smile from Tony Thompson.
Thompson's got a great poker face. You see him, doesn't open his mouth, he keeps his straight face straight, he smirks now and then, he walks back to the corner and it all comes out in the corner.
This has been a high-energy fight. You can see Price's bone. Good right hand there from Price, just leaned into that. David Price winging away to the body as well. Right uppercut. Price seems to be taking those well. If a little unnecessary, shot to the body. Price backed off there. And the crowd on their feet. Right hook. David Price, hey again, he backs off. Oh my word. Oh dear.
Well, listen,
it's captivating.
Get your feet
back. But you can't help but feel Price is fighting the wrong fight.
Okay, listen to me. Breathe. Breathe. Come on. Come on. Get your feet up. Get your feet back in this round, Price. You gotta move your feet in this round, okay? Yeah. Move your feet. Get your jab going. Keep your hands up. All right? Yeah. Come on.
He looks absolutely knackered, doesn't he?
He doesn't. Lennox Lewis is screaming from outside. They didn't get him up now. Stand up now. Stand up. Get yourself right now. And he has done. You know, that body shot hurt in that round. He's blowing. It's a lot about heart now. We know he's got plenty of it. Listen, he's showing it now, but he's got to really dig in now. You've got to stay tight, get back to basics, box, get your jab out, box. Find your openings that way, Alex.
Absolutely. Thompson raced off his stool. I'll tell you what, Paul's right. This comes down to heart, courage, and those miles on the road. This is going to be last man standing. The big question is who that man will be. Nice jab from Price. We know he can do that. Keep it simple. Just jab and jab and jab. Jab him for two or three rounds if you have to.
Exactly. I was just going to say, just take a round off. But you know, there's no shame and no harm in doing it. You can still win the round on your jab alone if your jab's good, which David's is.
Well, the psychology of the sport in boxing more than most others is so crucial, and there's no doubt that's played a big part. What happened 5 months ago is definitely affecting the action that's unfolding now. And the way David Price has gone about it. Tony Thompson having the last word here. Price is in trouble, he backs off. Price is just giving Thompson a chance that he doesn't need to give him.
And David needs to throw back here now.
Oh, he's played bloody nose. He's in trouble, Price. He's in trouble. His hands are down. He's bending over. What is he doing? He's falling apart at the seams for David Price, who wills under a right hand, trying to fight back. Big right hand from Tony Thompson, who's on the cusp of the upset again.
Price needs to throw back.
Back on the ropes, David Price. He's not doing enough with his hands. He's hardly defending himself. And the referee steps in and he gets a standing count. And David Price is buckled over and his boxing career is hanging by a thread. He's absolutely knackered and he's counted out! Tony Thompson shocks the world again! Disbelief ringside. And you can't help but feel that David Price was the architect of his own downfall. He had Thompson in trouble in the second. He had him under pressure in the third. But effectively, he punched himself out and he fought the wrong fight. Quite simply, he threw it away. Well, the two fighters embrace over on the far side. It was a hell of a fight while it lasted. And David Price fought like a warrior. you felt he didn't need to.
So many shots coming in from Thompson. Just David needed to throw back and answer back a little bit more, and it just wasn't happening, it just wasn't able to. The amount of shots coming in from Thompson, you know, they're not necessarily big, huge shots. He's just placing them there, he's picking them very nicely. That's experience.
We're shell-shocked, and we're about to get an announcement that we hoped we wouldn't hear, and many came here tonight not expecting to hear. David Price, he was spent, he was all in, and Marcus McDonald knew it. And in the end, he made the right decision. Sad confirmation coming up.
Ladies and gentlemen, before we declare the result, as always, please, your appreciation for both boxers in the ring. Our timekeeper Andrew East records an official time of 1 minute 55 seconds into round number 5. Marcus McDonald stops the contest with David Price in no position to continue. The winner from the USA, Tony the Tiger Thompson. And ladies and gentlemen, please, your appreciation, David Price.
Steve, you knew that wasn't going 12 after 3.